Okay, so I keep talking about this idea of making variations of your screens based on feedback or doing iterations and changes based on feedback because you want to generate as many of these different versions as you can just to see what all your alternatives are. So there's a feature in mockups called alternates. So you could right click or click drop down arrow next to a mockup in the navigator and look for this create alternate version menu item. There's also a panel, the inspector panel has a sub panel here that has alternate versions that you can use if you press the plus icon here. So if I select that, it creates an alternate version here. And this way you don't destroy or delete the previous versions, but you can create multiple versions of a single view or a single page based on reviews, design reviews you have. So you can double click that and then give it a new name based on whatever the name of your review was or the name of the feature change was, or you just leave it. These are generated alternates. So you can just continue to keep making new alternate versions here. And so the way this works is that you could make a change here. So maybe I just change, maybe we have added an image or something to this screen, or we change the background of the view. So let's make a change here that's visible. I'm just gonna change this green color just to make a visible change here. So now we have the alternate version that I just worked on, and then you can switch between alternates using the sub panel here. There's the official version that we had, and the official is the first one. And then, you can also use the dropdown next to the mockup name there. Once you're happy with the changes, you could promote your alternate to official if you had another review of all the variations that you worked on, and doing that would move the alternate up to the official one, and now we have this without the alternate name underneath. And once you have a bunch of alternates for a mockup, you'll see a little icon appear next to there to let you know that you can look at previous versions of that page. All right, so I'm going to also point out that there's a dropdown for the panel. And this way, if you have alternates on multiple screens, you could switch them all to the official versions if you're looking at a bunch of alternates. And that can be done for all of the mockups in your project. All right, so last thing is that you could merge something. So if I have, let's say, another alternate here, and I'm just gonna make this one this crazy red color. And the drop down here, you might have noticed before, has another menu item that says merge with official. So all this basically does is let you, see the official version with a copy of the alternate so that you can select parts of the alternate that you want to blend in with the original one, or if you only want to take changes from one of the alternates. So I'm going to send this back to the official, and then last thing you can do is you can either clone or discard alternates if you don't want them anymore. All right, so that's one little feature that you can use while you are making multiple iterations, multiple versions of each mockup. And this is a great feature for using with after design reviews. And next up, we're going to look at linking these wireframes together so that you can create a clickable prototype.